because I was right there. And, like, that door just opened right up for me.
This is the aftermath of a trip for Michelle Brune and her daughters Courtney and Kirsten.
None of us had gotten any sleep, so we thought, you know, let's not wait. Let's just get it. Let's just go. Let's get started. So we all kind of got in the car. We were all packed and ready. We just got in the car and left.
They left around 3, 4 a.m. for a 14-hour trip to Utah. 5 hours out near Ogallala, Michelle was getting sleepy.
Right before this happened, I actually even stopped at a rest stop. Got out, walked around, thought, okay, now I'm fine. Got back in the car, started driving again.
The car started to swerve, and then I woke up in the middle of the swerving.
The first thing that happened is I heard you go over the slats on the side of the road. I heard that, and I'm pretty sure that's what woke me up.
The Suburban rolled and slid on its roof for what Michelle says was a long time. Then it popped back on its wheels.
Some people keep running up to us. I mean, there were people just flying, and I heard a guy say, they're getting out of the car. I can't believe it. They're getting out of the car.
All three spent the day at the hospital with minor injuries. They all learned a valuable lesson.
We always have somebody sitting up with the driver to make sure that they're awake, and we don't leave as early anymore.
Rose White with AAA says there are lessons learned from this experience. Michelle stopped to walk around and wake up. That's good. But leaving as early as they did and with little to no sleep, bad idea.
Vehicles today are built for comfort, and so we're very comfortable and relaxed when we get inside of our vehicle. That in itself can also make us drowsy.
White also recommends having a passenger up front, keeping the driver engaged. She says it doesn't take much for a quick lapse to cause big problems.
If we're traveling 55 miles an hour, within 4 seconds, we've traveled the length of a football field. And so if your eyes are closed for any short distance, you can easily cross the center line and cause a very severe head-on collision.
Michelle found out the hard way.
You know, to be going that fast, I knew that it was set, so, and roll your car and to come out with really very few injuries, it was just a miracle.